Dear friends, good morning. I hope you had a wonderful night. This morning we want to make sure you understand what was the origin of the mark of the beast. To talk about the mark of the beast, you need to first understand there is no mark of the beast without first understand the seal of God. The seal of God is the identity one has to tell who you belong to. When God created Adam and Eve, he put on them his spirit, he breathed life in them. That is the identity of who they are, belonging to God. The Spirit of God is in them. They look alike. They were made at the image of God. After sin, now you have a new but not so different definition. The definition of the seal of God after Adam and Eve fall into the temptation of the devil became something very specific. The need for redemption is at the center of the seal of God. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 21, we saw something specific. Also, for Adam and his wife, the Lord God made tunics of skin and clothed them. So the Lord made for Adam and Eve clothes out of skin of animal. What type of animal was used? Genesis 3 verse 21 didn't tell, but later on, you will understand that according to John 1st, verse 29, it is said, he is the Lamb of the Lord who taketh away the sin of the world. It is believed that the skin of animal that was used to make clothing for Adam and Eve was none other but a lamb or lambs. The Lord didn't say who killed the animals out of which the clothing was made. It is believed that the person who killed the animals was God himself, which represent God, who will later kill his son as the redemption for all of us. You must understand now that the lamb represent Jesus Christ himself, was supposed to die for us. When you get there, you will find one thing, something specific that happened during the Exodus. The Exodus couldn't happen because something was missing. All the things that happened in Egypt, out of which there was one thing that's supposed to happen. They're supposed to be the blood. The blood was the one thing that saved the people from having the firstborn die that night. Each family was told to take a lamb. Where do we find that? Each family in Egypt was told to take a lamb. In Genesis 12, verse 3, it is said, speak to all the congregation of Israel, saying, on the 10th of this month, every man shall take for himself a lamb according to the house of his father, a lamb for a household. And they're supposed to kill the lamb 4 days after, and they're supposed to, and they shall take some of the blood and put it on the two door posts and on the lintel of the house where they eat it. So that is how they were saved. The angel of destruction will pass over and no one will be destroyed. That is the origin of the seal of God. If you didn't do that, then you have the mark of the beast. The mark of the beast has only and only one definition. The mark of the beast is a reference of those who fail to get the mark, the seal of God. Then you no longer resemble to God or having the image of God. You do now have the image of the one who didn't follow God. And the first one who failed to follow God was Lucifer becoming Satan. Therefore, you resemble to Satan because you follow its step. I will finish this meditation by telling you the mark of the beast is not something Satan will give. The Lord is giving it by to those who reject him. That is the most important things for you to know. Satan doesn't have a mark to give. Those who reject God won't have the seal of God. Therefore, you resemble to Satan. But there will be a time Satan will use his power to tell those who didn't get the seal of God that you are mine. And that's where we stop. We'll see you. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.